He's fresh from winning his second Everest with Nature Strip, and he's chasing his fifth Ladbrokes Cox Plate this weekend with Verry Elleegant. He is Chris Waller. G'day, Chris.
G'day.
Well, let's get straight into it. You're rolling into Ladbrokes Cox Plate week, a special week for you on the highest of highs, off the back of winning the Everest again and with a horse in Nature Strip who is really special to you.
Yeah, he sure is. Yeah, obviously all the punters know him for good and bad, but from our side, obviously we take it very personal when he doesn't win, and we know how good he is, we know how fast he is, but you need to get things right. And he and James certainly nailed it on Saturday, albeit a close victory. Masked Crusader was chiming in late, and the rest of the field, I think, ran very well. So, yeah, to come out on top after some great victories throughout his career, it was very rewarding.
And then you roll straight into Ladbrokes Cox Plate Week, a week that means so much to you after all of the year after year, four in a row for Winx.
Yes, it was quite unbelievable. It almost broke me, that's for sure, as what used to go into it. And the first one of her wins was pretty straightforward. She hadn't arrived, and neither had Hugh Bowman or Chris Wallace, for that matter. And both Hugh and I, when she won the race, we were extremely emotional for that simple reason. And then came the sense of having to back up and do it next year, the second year. And I think that was the build-up with Hartnell. And when they took off at the 800-metre mark, thankfully, it was pretty short-lived. I don't know if I could have lasted 800 metres like the Waverley Star on Bone Crusher Cox Plate. So, yeah, the next two were interesting. Obviously, we were expected to win each and every time, and then going back that fourth year, we just physically, we were really struggling. It was exhausting, but what a great result. So Cox Plate Week's a pretty special week.
It sure is. Tell us about when you did finally retire her.
I actually said to the owners post Cox Plate, my fourth Cox Plate, I said, oh, I think that's enough now. I don't know if I can do it again. And I've never said that publicly. I just thought, well, that's it. It's her job done. She's had a great career. I think now's a great time to call it a day. And I think they're a little bit taken back, as was Hugh. We gave it serious consideration, but the facts were she was so sound. She'd never had a cortisone injection in her life. She'd never had a day's unsoundness. Mentally, she was still great, and physically, she was good, and she was still winning. So we pushed towards another autumn.
One of the incredible aspects of the day that Winx retired was the day that Verry Elleegant really stamped herself and arrived, wasn't it? Gee, you know how to replace them.
A bit like Peter Moody with his comeback. It's been quite unbelievable, and she got Horse of the Year last year. So she just needs to prove herself around the valley. She went for a spin round there last Saturday. She seemed to get around it pretty well. She'll go once more prior to race day. So, look, we know she's good enough. She's coming off the back of a plain run, which is unusual for a good horse. Normally they don't have bad days, but she ran fourth. We found a few little – we just found that she was a bit flat. Soundness is good. Her appetite was a bit down on what it should be, and since then everything's back to normal. She's eating just as much now as she was going into the Caulfield Cup, which is more than what she was eating prior to Turnbull. So as the good old horseman will tell you, the feed bin's the best sign. If you've got a clean feed bin each morning, your horse is thriving. So that's the phase that Verry Elleegant's in now.
You mentioned the valley and just needing to get around. It was a total forgive, that one Cox Plate and the one run she's had here, though, after she missed the start.
I would genuinely be forgetting that. You've seen her form since then just go to a whole new level. So, yeah, I think she's a more mature, more tractable horse now, and she's ready for that Cox Plate pressure. I'm not worried about anything else. There's a lot of other horses that have to lift as well. We've just got to make sure Verry Elleegant's at her best, and she'll be fighting out the finish.
Can't let you go, Chris. I know he's not your horse, but Nature Strip grabbed the headlines. So too did Incentivise. As a trainer, you must have been in awe of his Caulfield Cup win.
Unbelievable. I couldn't believe he won, to tell you the truth. Look, Brett Prebble never panicked. He could have easily pushed the urgent button and led going out of the straight. He didn't. He kept the horse in a nice rhythm, but gee, he covered some ground. Then he got into a beautiful spot. But again, Brett knew what he had under him and he started to roll from a long way out. Gee, not many horses can do that, and he is a superstar. It's as simple as that.
Thanks very much, Chris. Wonderful to reminisce about Winx, and the best of luck to you and the team with Verry Elleegant.
Many thanks.